You feeling good? Let me hear you say alright.
And what up?
Alright.
Pooh Bear.
I'm feeling good, so I'm saying myself. Alright.
Claudia.
Alright.
How you gonna do this?
This one goes out to the baby girls in a rush growing up in this crazy world. Yeah, your brother on the road and he never home. I know you're feeling kinda sad now that daddy gone. You can't let it get you down, gotta carry on. We only lose things because it makes us strong. You always had my love and now you got a song. From the biggest, biggest fan that you've ever known. I know you won't be little girls, not for very long. And you ain't gotta have a man if you don't ever want. Cause I'ma make sure you got to it. Everything that you ever want, every tone that you've ever owned. Not to make it hard to respect, just really, 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 really hard to impress. It's a whole wide world for you to go and get your hands on. Until then, I just come and get your dance on, man. You misunderstood, never had money, or you living good. If you're from the burbs, if you're in the hood, recognize where we come from. In my day, man, I did a little something. They like, how come you don't rap that? Cause that's a backtrack, and I ain't tryna backpack. I'm only moving forward, homie, that's that. Direction, a lot of shoulders lack that. I'm just tryna give it to him like sat nav. Now I know I might not make it like a fat rat. That's cool, as long as he don't trap crack. Graduate from school, and still let his pants sag. Never catch a case, know how to let his cash stack. Welcome to the map, go anyway, tap back, man.
I'ma give you the lowdown.
The way and you for so long. Know that in this world you're never really on your own. God got a number, get him on the phone. He'll never put you places where you don't belong. Put you through the pain to put you on the throne. And I know that from the bottom of my cold song. And if they're looking at you sideways, you just wave right back, tell them hi, hey. Mad you ain't hanging with him in the driveway. Nah, we gon' keep moving to the highway. Strong's putting on. The week is all over like Friday, chilling. Shout out to King David for bringing in the feeling. And I'm a pretty independent woman in the building. Let's go.
Temple of hip hop,
temple of hip hop,
hip hop, hip hop, hip hop.
Today is a different day.
Is everybody all right?
Yeah.
All right.
Temple of hip hop,
hip hop.
About to begin. Temple of hip hop,
hip hop, hip hop, hip
hop. Temple of hip hop,
hip hop.
In the name of the force who is the source who is called by many names, Allah, Jehovah, Yahweh, Elohim, Jah, El Nur, El Kalum, the All. And we give praise to the Creator and we give praise for all you human beings who's down here on this planet, so-called Earth, and to all the extraterrestrial beings in other planets and other places and other dimensions throughout our universe and universes. I greet all of y'all with the greeting words of peace.
Temple of hip hop.
If you choose to be here today, then I just gotta say you are hip hop, for real.
Today is a different day. because we can see that what we disseminate to the world, and I have been privileged, without joining the military, to travel the entire planet Earth with turntables. All right? Y'all feel me?
There's a lot of deep things going on out here. We are all on a war for the mind of the masses of our people. And we ain't talking about just black people. We talking about black, brown, yellow, red, and white human beings on this planet, so-called Earth.
Temple of hip-hop.
First, let's get into this thing they call rap. Rap is part of the hip-hop culture. Hip-hop is not part of the rap culture.
Temple of hip-hop.
So I understand, I know now, when I look at things, I can analyze things, I'm thinking on a high level. Hip-hop is not just song and dance. It is a metaphysical experience that everyone needs to understand.
Temple of hip-hop, temple of hip-hop, 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 hip-hop.
Peace. I'm KRS-One, founder and first teacher of the Temple of Hip-Hop. These teachings are designed to raise your self-worth as a hip-hop scholar and get you familiar with the way in which our temple approaches hip-hop. These teachings are unique to the Temple of Hip-Hop and should not be compared to any other study or school of thought regarding hip-hop. Our teachings reflect the evidence of our research. In no way whatsoever do we claim that our interpretation of hip-hop is the one and only true interpretation of hip-hop. It is not. Hip-hop is far more vast and complex than the teachings of one group or person. Our aim here is to introduce you to the Temple of Hip-Hop's body of knowledge regarding hip-hop so that you may make an informed choice as to your apprenticeship with the Temple of Hip-Hop. Let's get started. The Temple of Hip-Hop is a hip-hop preservation society and ministry. We began in 1996 with the declaration, rap is something we do, hip-hop is something we live. Since then, we've researched the nature and essence of hip-hop in search of its continual patterns and possible purpose. What we've uncovered was that the living of hip-hop was far more productive and fulfilling than the performing of hip-hop. What does this mean? When an average person thinks of hip-hop today, they often think of rappers and rap music. And this is fine if you are simply a consumer of music product. But if you are attempting to create a lasting career in hip-hop or raise a family living hip-hop, a surface understanding of hip-hop as rap music entertainment is simply not going to get you very far. Success in any field of life requires knowledge. And in the highly competitive world of hip-hop, success depends upon superior knowledge. This is what your apprenticeship with the Temple of Hip-Hop is all about. We have observed that it is not one's talent that ensures one's longevity. Even with great talent and/or inheritance, it is one's personal character that truly ensures one's professional success and longevity. We have observed too many talented people, artists and otherwise, fail to maintain successful careers even with great skills because of the shortcomings of their own personal characters. Your apprenticeship with the Temple of Hip-Hop includes the spiritual and ethical principles of hip-hop itself. Our approach to hip-hop is both natural and supernatural, both scientific and spiritual. First, let us deal with the scientific and natural aspects of hip-hop.
It started about me like loving music. It started from me as a kid, born in Jamaica, Kingston, hearing the big sound system and my, at nighttime playing. See the guys with a hand cart bringing the sound system, or sometime a big truck, huge sound system. And it wasn't about the discotheque. If you had a big yard, the yard was cement and a high zinc fence all around it, so you couldn't look inside, and some pretty Christmas lights around. And it's like a big festival, like, you know, curry goat was being sold. You had goat head soup, red stripe beer. and you smell all different type of weed and herb. And you see all the famous gangsters roll up, all the famous bad men that come up and who the man there? Yo, Claudia myself. What? Yeah, man, bad man from East, West, still up, till all of them places. But anyway, I didn't know that was gonna stick in my brains. And my mom's come down from the States because she was studying for a nursing. And she used to bring back music like Smokey Robinson, Temptation. But James Brown came down to Jamaica and he had a record called I Feel Good. For some reason, James Brown, I fell in love with James Brown. And James Brown to me is the A1 B-boy. James Brown is to me the A1 rap master. James Brown was talking to me like Bob Marley was talking to me through his music. You know what I'm saying? And with that day coming to the States in 67, I was listening to Cousin Brucey. You know, but it was something come along that the kids was identifying and having fun and the adults wanted to knock it all the time. But it kept on and it kept on and kept on.
Temple of hip hop, hip hop.
Know this, hip-hop and rap are not the same things. Rap is something that is done, while hip-hop is something that is lived. Hip-hop is the behavior that produces the act of rapping. Without hip-hop, rap has no life and no meaning. Rap, rhythmic speech, is but one expression that comes out of the total hip-hop experience. Traditionally, hip-hop has been approached as an art form that consists of b-boying, breakdancing, MCing, rap, aerosol art, graffiti writing, and DJing, the cutting, mixing, and scratching of recorded materials. These are called the core four. However, hip-hop's core four elements also encompass specific and unique clothing styles, language styles, business and trade techniques, as well as a collective body of knowledge derived from its internal experiences with itself and the world. The experiences produced by the activity of hip-hop's core four have created uniquely rich stories, legends, and myths, original arts, popular music, and thought-provoking poetry that critiques and interprets the world in which the hip-hop community exists. At first glance, hip-hop can be seen as simply an urban music genre inspired by African-American and Latino youths of the Bronx during the early 1970s. However, upon closer observation, hip-hop becomes a specific way of seeing the world, a unique view of the physical world and world events. We are uniquely hip-hop because the repetition of such a unique being and seeing has created our specific hip-hop way of life. And the hip-hop way of life is what we call hip-hop's culture, or hip-hop culture. As culture, hip-hop is the specific behaviors, traits, expressions, patterns, and institutions of our unique collective consciousness. It is our intellectual and artistic activity as well as the works produced by it. It, hip-hop, is the amplification of our human expression and awareness. At its essence, hip-hop is not just an art form. It is the pursuit of our own authentic being through the arts. As an apprentice of the Temple of Hip-Hop, you are studying to become an authentic hip-hop scholar, not just a fan of rap music folklore. For you, hip-hop is not over there somewhere external of yourself. You are hip-hop. Such an approach to hip-hop is both scientific and spiritual.
When God talked to the prophets, he was rapping. And when the prophets talked back to God, they was rapping. And then if we want to bring it up and get all up to the modern days and ages, we could start going in the 60s when you had Shirley Ellis when she did the Name Game and the Clapping Song. We could go to the poetry rapping of Sister Sonia Sanchez with the Watts Poets or the Last Poets. We could get into the political or the message rap of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, Malcolm X, or the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. We could get into the party and fun raps of Pig Meat Markham, Mobs Mailey. We could go back to the Heidi Heidi Ho with Cab Calloway. We could go back to the radio disc jockey of Jocko, Eddie OJ, and all the others that did things. We could go back to the love rap of Isaac Hayes, Black Moses, to the love rap of Barry White out there. This is all part of rap. And if all you country people want to get into the country and western thing, we can take it to Tony Joe White when he did Pope Salad Annie. This is all dealing with the rap. Rap.
Temple of hip hop, hip hop.
The term hip-hop itself is not a person, a place, or a physical thing. You cannot actually go to hip-hop, or wear hip-hop, or eat hip-hop. You cannot drink a can of hip-hop and suddenly know how to rap. You cannot put hip-hop on as clothing or read a book in order to understand hip-hop. Hip-hop begins as an awareness, as a shared idea. Hip-hop is an alternative urban behavior that belongs to no one person individually. It is a collective consciousness. Hip-hop is the name of our collective urban consciousness. Rapping, breakdancing, graffiti art, beatboxing, and DJing are all expressions of this collective urban consciousness commonly called hip-hop. Hip-hop is a new global urban understanding that communicates an alternative social reality through art. Hip-hop is a new faculty in the collective consciousness of urban America. It is understood psychically by those who participate in it. More than just a music genre, hip-hop is an international urban agreement. Resting upon these facts, the preservation of hip-hop rests not with the preservation of its products, but with the preservation of itself. The preservation of hip-hop begins with the preservation of itself as a creative force, which is the preservation of a certain attitude about life. Preserving the specific artifacts and memorabilia of rap music has its place and its importance, and someone should be doing that work. Such work is indeed a strength to the preservation of our culture. However, as a temple, we are more concerned with the essence, substance, force, being, cause, and identity of hip-hop as a creative force. The preserving of such a force has little to do with the preserving of its products. It has to do with understanding the force itself, the essence that causes such products to exist. With this in mind, we seek to preserve and develop the collective consciousness of our social group, hip-hop. From our perspective, the preserving of hip-hop has more to do with the preservation of its people than with the preserving of its products. Hip-hop's preservation has to do with the preserving of certain customs, traditions, and techniques unique to the cause of the hip-hop experience. This is the essence of our hip-hop preservation movement. Study carefully. Your apprenticeship has already begun. What is real hip-hop? The quick answer is that it is the combination of breaking, MCing, graffiti writing, DJing, and beatboxing. However, real relates to fixed or immovable things like land. When hip-hop is real to you, when it is fixed and immovable from your being, you are practicing real hip-hop. When something is real, it is considered to be genuine and or authentic. It is what it proposes to be. It is not imaginary. It is actually existing and occurring to our physical senses. The term real hip-hop relates to the fixed conditions and genuine nature of hip-hop as it appears to our physical senses today. Breaking, MCing, graffiti art, DJing, beatboxing, street fashion, street language, street knowledge, and street entrepreneurialism are all fixed conditions of hip-hop. These elements are permanent and immovable from the existence of hip-hop. These elements are real hip-hop. And those who promote and preserve these elements promote and preserve real hip-hop. When these elements are not present in one's self-expression, one is not doing or being real hip-hop. True hip-hop scholars are studying to become hip-hop, not just to observe it. How can anyone claim any authority or any authentic scholarship on something that they themselves cannot do? Where then is your authority to teach? Our perspective on hip-hop and its culture is not an objective one. We love hip-hop. We live hip-hop. And we are not ashamed or afraid to say we are hip-hop. Your apprenticeship establishes the existence and preservation of our hip-hop community. We are strong in our unity of thought. Our truth is self-evident. We must first believe that we exist, and then we must perceive the powers of our own existence. We must first believe that we exist if we are to develop ourselves into a strong hip-hop community capable of raising our collective quality of life. Only we can do this for ourselves. No one else is responsible for us and our spiritual, cultural development. We must align our collective thoughts and actions as hip-hoppers with what we know to be real for us in the material world. We must see the physical results of that which we claim to spiritually believe. Otherwise, we are living in denial and fantasy as others do. This is what your apprenticeship really means to hip-hop. You are the actual historical evidence that hip-hop was conscious of itself in its early days. Yes, we practice real hip-hop. We practice the immovable and fixed conditions of the hip-hop spirit. I come to hip-hop with no other interest but to authentically manifest it. This is real hip-hop.
Hip-hop needs to be involved in the community more. You use the ghetto to get out. But once you get out, you don't want to give back. But soon as the cop busts up side your head, you want to run back to the neighborhood and say, come out to the courthouse or come to the precinct and protest. It don't work like that. Chris, you got your thing, man. And Cindy, that young lady right there, my sister, she was the one that's responsible for the jam. Because she asked me to play for her party when I was a graffiti artist. And that's when I graduated from off the wall onto the flyers. For her party, and everybody came out and said, when is the next party? Cindy, thank you. And always thanks to you, Cindy. The first lady of hip-hop, Cindy.
Our unity declares the reality of a hip-hop nation. And because we willingly choose to fix ourselves to the spirit of hip-hop and not move from it, it is a fact that we practice real hip-hop in our time. We make hip-hop real by authentically being it. This is real hip-hop.
We from the hood and we in the hood. Let's love the hood. Let's love each other, homie. Let's be what we want to be. Let's get all the money we want to get. Let's stay alive. Let's stay free. Free, free, free.
Real hip-hop is real life. And it is from the experiences of our real lives that our songs, our dances, our graphic arts, and our language come from. However, the hood is not just about illegal drugs and crime. The hood got a lot of things going on in it. Positive, productive activities go on all the time in the hood. There's a lot of love and even respect in the hood. And when you represent the real activities of the hood in song, in dance, in graphic art, in fashion, in language, you are practicing real hip hop.
What we do today affects tomorrow. That's why everything that we do today, we have to think about the things that we do today. When I got into hip hop, I got into it because it was fun. It was a way of expressing ourselves. It was like, it was a way out. They took all the music programs out of all the schools. So when they took them out of the schools, all we had, you know, this is where this whole poem came from. It said, we the willing, led by the unknowing, are doing the impossible for the ungrateful. We have done so much for so long with so little that we are now qualified to do anything with nothing. And that's where hip hop comes from. That's the core of where hip hop comes from, and that's what it's all about. It's about appreciating, it's about giving back, it's about showing love to brothers and sisters, you know. It's about not getting caught up in the bling bling and the ching ching. You know what I'm saying? And try to do the right thing. You know, try to give back to the younger brothers and sisters around your neighborhood. Try to give back to your family. Because hip-hop is one family. We are all one family. Family, family, family.
The music and dances of hip-hop come from a collective urban view of the world that inspires such music and dance to exist. It is hip-hop's worldview that inspires, or rather causes, its music, art, and dance to exist. This is why so many of the hip-hop history books today are so culturally limited. They focus primarily upon the money-making effects of hip-hop and not upon what causes such effects to occur. It's like telling only the middle of a story with no beginning and no ending. Music and art are very important elements that assist in the makeup of hip-hop as a whole. However, it is hip-hop itself, our collective consciousness, that brings into manifestation rap music, breaking, and aerosol art. Our unique life experiences and the performances that occur as a result of such unique life experiences are called real hip-hop. For us, real hip-hop is a transformative power that has its beginnings at the genesis of human awareness. Hip-hop has always existed as a unique awareness that enhances one's ability to self-create. Hip-hop is a sight, an ancient behavior, today an alternative way to view the world. As an acronym affirmation, hip-hop, H-I-P-H-O-P, can be interpreted as her infinite power helping oppressed people, or having inner peace helping others prosper, or wholly integrated people having omnipresent power. Hip-hop means all of this. Those who show little respect for hip-hop still spell hip-hop in lowercase letters, though. True hip-hop scholars are advised to spell hip-hop beginning with a capital H. Hip-hop, capital H, lowercase I, lowercase P, space, capital H, lowercase O, and lowercase P. Hip-hop. We capitalize the two H's in hip hop because it is the name of our social group. It is the force that animates our way of life, our culture, our tribe. Hip hop is the name of our nation. When hip hop is spelled in lowercase, it usually refers to rap music product and its related activities. It does not and cannot relate to a people. To spell hip hop incorrectly in lowercase letters is to deny our right to exist as a people. The use of the lowercase hip hop to describe real people reduces those people to products. According to Common English, hip means to have knowledge of. It is a form of intelligence. Hop is a form of movement, a springing upward. Together, hip and hop means moving or jumping intelligence, even knowledgeable movement. Hip hop, moving intelligence, active intelligence. Intelligence moving, conscious movement.
You know, one of the things that's interesting about me is that I have a different history on hip hop that a lot of people may not have. I was there. You know what I mean? It's not like I heard about it. I was actually there. I used to go home, you know, and I used to sneak out my house and I used to go over to, you know, the Celebrity Club, Randy's Place, Harlem World. I mean, the Fever, you know, the Autobahn. I mean, we could keep going and on with this. Just to watch this, I used to come up in the projects when Bam had the jams going on. I used to be there, so it's a different level of appreciation that you have for something when you've been there. Sometimes people don't appreciate things because they never been there.
The etymology of the term hip-hop, as it relates to the English language, begins with the term hip, meaning the joint formed by the upper thigh bone and pelvis. This is the joint used the most in our breaking moves and most urban dance moves, the hips. In addition to the term hip being interpreted as part of the skeletal structure of the human body, we hop out of the hips. Hip is also the seed pod of a rose bush and is also interpreted as to be informed or to be up to date. Hop, on the other hand, appears in the English language as hoppin, meaning to spring or to move by springing, usually upon one foot. This term, hoppin, seems to come from the Old English hoppin, meaning to spring or to dance. This term corresponds with the Old Icelandic hoppa, H-O-P-P-A, the modern Dutch hoppen, H-O-P-P-E-N, and the German hopfen, H-O-P-F-E-N, all meaning to hop or to spring. Like the term hip, the term hop is also associated with plant life. Hop is interpreted as a vine having flower clusters like wheat or barley. The hop plant was and still is used to flavor malt drinks like beer. These are the English etymologies of the term hip and hop. And we can see here within these definitions how even hip and hop come together to mean hip, informed, and hop, springing or dancing. Together, the term hip hop can mean an informed springing or an up-to-date modern dance or an informed movement upward. A hip updated hop movement is an intelligent movement, a movement aware of itself. The term hip-hop culture seems to imply the cultivation of and care for the upward springing of intelligence. There seems to be a symbolic connection to farming when it comes to the etymology of the words hip, hop, and culture. as defined within the English language. Symbolically, we seem to be growing in ancient intelligence with an ancient meaning and purpose. Well, finally, within the etymology of hip-hop, we come to the hip-hoppa, spelled H-I-P-H-O-P-P-A. The term hip meaning keenly aware of what is new and in style, and hoppa meaning to spring upward or to hop, reveals the hip-hopper as the actual intelligence that is springing forward. The hip-hopper, technically and literally, is a conscious mover, or one who moves with awareness, an informed mover.
At this level of the game, it's not about money. And I think that we don't have the appreciation that we should have for the brothers that paved the way. You know, and I think that it's real important to acknowledge them, you know, and let them know that, you know, we love them. You know, sometimes brothers feel like it's too much to say, I love my brother, you know, or show that love in demonstration. You know, my sister, a soldier, used to tell me, you know, love is a demonstrative word that's proven through an action. So, you know, you got to demonstrate that love. And demonstrating that love sometimes is not in the form of always, you know, money. It's just in the form of acknowledgement and appreciation.
Real hip hop is all about peace, love, unity, and safely having fun. This vision is what is common to most of the peoples of the earth. And this is why hip-hop appeals to most of the earth's people. We speak a universal language. Such is the meaning of your apprenticeship. Your hip-hop spiritual path begins with you learning how to create and guide thought, beginning with your own. What you think of repeatedly, you become. Therefore, the hip-hop spiritual path begins with a faith in our own existence as hip-hoppers. First, we must learn to honor ourselves and our history. Here, you must finally stop doubting yourself and realize your limitlessness within hip-hop. For when your inner truth is louder than your outer circumstances, you have learned to live and walk in your hip-hop spirit reality.
It's like the people who fought for certain things for us to be able to live the way we live now, as far as our comfort zone, and we are spoiled by it. And we don't really acknowledge it and value it the way we should, because we take so much for granted by not valuing it because of how we treat it in the current day. And I guess a lot of the time you don't appreciate certain things until you experience the worst in the situation, and once you already knee deep in the ass of the situation, that's when you start turning around looking for help. Help, 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 help.
Those that have gospels of hip hop in their possession, you can open your gospel to the first overstanding entitled Real Hip Hop. Turn to page 80. In between paragraphs 103 and 104, you will see the three natures of hip hop. Hip-hop exists as three distinct natures. These natures come together to create the total hip-hop experience. The first nature of hip-hop is hip-hop, spelled capital H, lowercase I, lowercase p, lowercase h, lowercase o, lowercase p. One word, hip-hop. It looks like hi-fop. But this hip-hop nature is our unique spirit, our unique collective consciousness, the creative force behind hip-hop's elements. Hip-hop is the name of our lifestyle and collective consciousness. The second nature of hip-hop is spelled capital H, lowercase I, lowercase p, space, capital H, lowercase o, lowercase p. This hip-hop is the creation and development of breaking, emceeing, graffiti art, DJing, beatboxing, street fashion, street language, street knowledge, and street entrepreneurialism. It is what we call ourselves and our activity in the world. This hip-hop is the name of our culture. Finally, the third nature of hip-hop is lowercase h, lowercase I, lowercase p, dash, lowercase h, lowercase o, and lowercase p. This hip-hop represents rap music product and those things and events associated with rap music entertainment. This hip-hop is a music genre. Now look at this. You have hip-hop 1, hip-hop 2, hip-hop 3, the three natures of hip-hop. Hip-hop 1 is consciousness. Hip-hop 2 is culture. Hip-hop 3 is product. Hip-hop culture is the name of our unique community of consciousness. Hip-hop, one, is the spirit, which creates the hip-hopper mind, which creates hip-hop, the culture, the body, which then creates hip-hop, the product, the expression. Hip-hop, one, the spirit, is born of God, the great spirit, the great event. It is the light of our world. Hip-hop 2, hip-hop, is born of cultural syncretism, meaning the blending of different cultures to create a new culture. It is the combination and unity of several independent cultures creating a new heterogeneous culture. And finally, hip-hop 3, rap music product, is born of corporate business interests. It exists when the effects of conscious hip-hop and cultural hip-hop become tradable material products. We've already learned now that hip-hop is not an object, that it is a subject, and that as a subject, it never really enters the physical world. Hip-hop is an idea that you become in order to express its elements. So right at the beginning, we could see that hip-hop really exists in the realm of ideas, thoughts, vibrations, influences, etc. And to handle real hip-hop, such handling must be done mentally. Real hip-hop is a mental activity. You don't really handle hip-hop with your hands. You handle hip-hop with your mind.
Hip-hop for me started around 1973-74. When I got into the game, this brother here was playing a certain type of music, talking about Kool Herc. Now these particular records had what was called passages of music, which is later was called the break. Now this is where I came into the game. Now my science is, for every good record, there's a great part. So what I had to do is figure out a way to take this teeny tiny section where it only broke down for like maybe 30 seconds and extend it to 4, 5, 6 minutes. It took a lot of figuring out how needles work, how does the torque of a turntable work, the state of inertia, so all the way up to speed, the type of needles, elliptical versus conical, the size, the grams, the tracking. Once I was able to figure all that out, I had to figure out a way to take this section and just repeat it over and over and over again. It was a 2-year period at my mother's house, straight from school or straight from work, and coming up with this science. And coming up with it, I'll never forget when I first displayed it in the parks, I said to myself, well, I'm playing the most climatic part of these records. So if I can figure out a way to just keep playing them one after another without you being able to tell, I'm gonna have you going crazy. So I'm like, yeah, okay. So when I went out in the park and I tried this and I did this, the audience was doing exactly what you're doing. At that point in time, I felt quite discouraged. Let me tell you why. I'm saying to myself, I'm playing these passages of music. I'm going right to the meat of the sandwich, the break of this record to the break of this record on time, one after another. And nobody's going berserk. Nobody's going nuts. It's like no asses is wiggling. Any children in here? Hope not. Nobody's moving. To my dismay, I figured out that I needed some sort of vocal entertainment. God bless the dead cowboy. I would have to say, my first MC Cowboy, he probably was the one person who kept my spirits up. Because me doing this without the vocal entertainment, the MCing, I might have given up. I might have said, you know, I was hearing things like, well, this is ridiculous fucking noise this guy's doing with these records, you know. I heard this record before, and why is it that he keeps going back to the same part over and over and over and over and over and over and over again? This guy, he's stupid, he's an idiot, he's like losing his mind, he's whatever. You know, once myself and Cowboy came up with a science, because he was like a ringmaster or Simon Says type of person. He was able to get people to be occupied. He was like the guy that just get people off of me, which is what I needed. And once that happened, it was on. From there, all DJs who were DJs had to change their styles totally. This was the new game in town. You had to do this, or you weren't the shit, so to speak. From there, I started going into clubs, and I'll just end it here. When I go into a long story, I would go to the clubs and ask DJs, can I get on for 4 or 5 minutes? These jocks would be like, you know, the fuck out of here, you know. You're gonna scratch up the records. When in actuality, when you are queuing, you are scratching a record back anyway. The only difference is you just push it out to the people. So their ignorance was their problem. But it wasn't until I met a gentleman by the name of DJ Hollywood in Club 371. He let me get on. And then I went to a club called Disco Fever. And there was a fella by the name of Junebug. He let me on. So the other clubs, eventually, they had to let me on because people wanted to see that. And that's basically my claim to this game. Just like, you know, I was considered like a human sampler. So what is done now, where a person takes a record and put it into this machine and a computer and a loop, before it was called a loop, I was the loop, you know, going back and forth. So that's what my contribution to this game is. Thank you.
Most people feel that if they do not rap or break or do aerosol art, that they have no need to understand hip hop. And they are partially correct, until they are reminded that hip-hop is one of the last of the human skills. It doesn't matter what you may think of a rapper or rap music, rapping itself is still a human skill. In fact, rapping is one of the last things modern humans can still do today without technological dependency. Plus, rap, rhythmic speech, and its brother, breakin', rhythmic dance, are both physically healthy and mentally stimulating. Breaking is physical exercise, and emceeing is mental exercise. It doesn't matter what these activities are in the music and theater industries, breaking and emceeing as human exercises for both mind and body are simply healthy for human beings. Breaking moves are used in aerobics and other exercises that refine the body and relieve stress. Dance appears at the genesis of human awareness and remains at the center of good health. Breaking gets our hearts pumping at about 120 beats per minute, and if we can break or dance at least 3 times a week for only 20 minutes, we would have enhanced our physical health and prolonged our very lives by years. MCing is the mastery of the spoken word. It is in the mastering of MCing that we also express our inherent understanding of rhythm, linguistics, physics, mathematics, memory, logical reasoning, and high communication skills. MCing expresses a total integration of right and left brain coordination. It doesn't matter what we may think of certain b-boys, b-girls, and or rappers or DJs. Breaking and MCing are simply healthy human skills. In a world that is becoming more and more technologically dependent, it is healthy to practice the elements of hip-hop as human skills, not just as artistic performances. Breaking, rapping, drawing, writing, and beatboxing are all human skills. They can be produced with no technological assistance at all. Respect is also a human skill. And the more we show respect to one another, the more humane we actually are. Communication with one's higher self, one's perceived higher source, is also a human skill. Weaving and sewing are human skills. Swimming, running, fighting, speaking, imagination, and sexual intercourse are all human skills. This is what the teaching of hip-hop emphasizes. It points out one's human abilities beyond one's technological understanding. This is important because in a world of text messaging and emailing, people seem to be losing their ability to communicate face-to-face as well as correctly apply their own human skills. The skills that it once took to think and convey one's thoughts to another person in person are fading fast. People are forgetting how to actually write with their hands, or express their emotions, or even feel the same of others. Privacy is becoming a thing of the past, while people actually laugh less writing LOL as opposed to actually laughing out loud. Imagine that. Some have actually allowed technology to interpret their very laughter, originally a human thing to do. The teaching of hip-hop restores all of this, or at least warns against it. It is not every day that we get real opportunities to be human, and when such opportunities arise, it is our very characters that are tested and even revealed. Human beings love, and we express love in the form of appreciation and respect. Without love, appreciation, and respect, nothing can be learned. Hip-hop reminds us of our humanity. Everything about hip-hop is human. Besides the commercial or even aesthetic value of hip-hop's core elements, hip-hop is simply a useful and safe way for human beings to spend their time. Simple and plain, hip-hop enhances human life.
Start listening, start thinking, start moving. It's important. I was shot when I was 12 years of age. It was the worst thing and the baddest thing and the sickest thing ever happened. And imagine if I'd have died. I'm 25 now. There wouldn't ever been this. I would never been able to step here and say, stop the violence. So stop the violence.
This concludes part one of the Temple of Hip Hop Orientation CD. This orientation continues on CD number 2.
We begin to wrestle.
special.